Okay. Minachi Nayan. Okay, we can start. For this afternoon session on Tuesday, it is my pleasure to have three speakers. And the first speaker is a good friend of mine. It's Paco Marcellan. He will be talking about from orthogonal polynomials on the real line to orthogonal polynomials on the unit circle. A matrix approach beyond the Szegő transformations. Please, Paco, go ahead.
Okay, thanks, Walter. It's a pleasure to be online with Soshi. I apologize, I cannot move since I received my second dose of Moderna just last Sunday. And I think from now on, I will able to move to places where it is possible to have not online activities. Okay, I am very proud to be with all friends, and I appreciated very much the kind invitation by the organizers. The title of my talk is related with a matrix approach beyond the Szegő transformations from orthogonal polynomials with respect to probability measures supported on the interval -1, 1 to the unit circle. And this is a joint work with María José Cantero, Leandro Moral, and Luis Velázquez. Then the outline of the presentation will have, first of all, some introduction about OPRL, orthogonal polynomials on the real line, and orthogonal polynomials on the unit circle. Next, I will present the so-called Szegő connection. And the next step will be focused on the dB zeta connection coming from Maxim Derebiagin.
We don't see your screen.
No?
No. At least I don't see it. I see the program, not your talk.
Oh. Is here?
So maybe this is that. Okay.
Now?
Yes, now it's okay.
It's okay. Okay. Yeah. Good. Then the idea is to analyze connections between orthogonal polynomials on the real line and orthogonal polynomials on the unit circle, following some ideas in a very nice paper by Maxim Derebiagin, Litvinet, and Alexei Zdanov. And finally, we will introduce our main result is the so-called generalized DVC connection. Okay, let's remind what is the idea about the orthogonal polynomials of the real line. Notice that these orthogonal polynomials are associated with a measure supported on the real line. And the idea is to consider the canonical basis and use the well-known Gram-Schmidt process in order to obtain the sequence of orthogonal polynomials. Then this polynomial satisfies a three-term recurrence relation. Everybody now this main result. But the important thing is that this three-term recurrence relation can be represented in a matrix form by using a Jacobi matrix. Jacobi matrix means a three-diagonal symmetric matrix. Then this matrix, capital G, will play central role in the sequence. On the other hand, you can also consider orthogonal polynomials on the unit circle. That means you consider the canonical basis with positive powers of zeta and apply Jahn-Schmidt. But there is a problem about the matrix representation of the multiplication operator, since this matrix is not, in general, unitary. That means the unitary character depends on some properties of the measure. In particular, the measure cannot belong to the Szegő class. Then, instead of the use of orthogonal polynomials on the unit circle, I consider Lorentz orthogonal polynomials. That means I consider the basis of Lorentz polynomials, a canonical basis, with this order. And then immediately we apply the Jahn-Schmidt process. Then these polynomials, these Lorentz orthogonal polynomials, satisfies a five-term recomposition relation in the sense that you can consider a matrix representation of this operator, and this matrix is called the CMB matrix. It's important to notice that in these entries of the matrix are involved the so-called Bernoulli or Schur parameters, as well as these quantities defined as rho n of 1 minus absolute value of a n squared 1 half. Okay, then there is a relation between orthogonal polynomials on the unit circle and orthogonal Lorentz polynomials, in the sense that you can represent these orthogonal Lorentz polynomials in terms of orthogonal polynomials on the unit circle. And then you have these families which are related in the way I indicated here. Okay, the important thing about this five diagonal matrix is that you have a factorization in terms of two tridiagonal matrices. But indeed, these tridiagonal matrices are diagonal block matrices, such that the blocks have this representation involving Schur parameters at the values rho n. In such a way, you can consider that the action of this matrix in terms of the basis of orthonormal Lorentz polynomials can be represented in this way. That means you have the connection between orthogonal Lorentz polynomials and the symmetric elements, the reverse orthogonal polynomials. It's very well now the connection between orthogonal polynomials on the unit circle and orthogonal polynomials on the real line. This was done by Gaber Szegő, and the idea is to consider the representation of the unit circle on the interval negative 2, 2. In such a way, you consider x as zeta plus zeta power negative 1. That means you have 2 times cosine theta. This is the way that you have the representation of the boundary of the circle, of the unit circle, on the interval negative 2, 2. Then you can consider the measure supported on the unit circle, and then you have a measure supported on the real line. But it is very important to say that this measure on the unit circle satisfies a very important property. The parameters, the Bernoulli parameters, are real numbers. Okay, indeed, there is a strong connection between orthogonal polynomials on the real line and orthogonal polynomials on the unit circle. And the relation is given in some explicit way by this formula. And On the other hand, you can find the connection between the entries of the Jacobi matrix and the parameters of the three-term recurrence relation in some sense. Okay, then once I have this connection, the Derevyagin-Binet-Sedanov connection is another approach to the link between Jacobi matrices and CMB matrices. Indeed, this is related with a very well known fact. As the Levinson algorithm. And then the idea is very simple. You consider the CMB matrix, and you can define the corresponding Jacobi matrix following the idea of Szegő. And then you consider a sieved transformation in the variable in order to have a new CMB matrix. For this CMB matrix, immediately by using Szegő, you have a new Jacobi matrix. Then you can consider again what happens with this matrix G tilde, since this matrix is nothing else as the Jacobi matrix associated to the Christoffel transformation of the measure. Then we have orthogonal polynomials on the unit circle, that means real Verbrunsky or Schur parameters, and then you can establish the connection between them. Then the idea now is to consider a generalization of the Derevyagin-Binet-Zdanov, and it is posed as a eigenvalue problem. The idea is the following. Notice that I have showed you that there is a connection between the factor matrices involved in the CMB representation. And then the idea is to generate a new three-diagonal matrix defined as L plus a parameter lambda capital M. That means you consider a pencil associated with the matrices capital L and M. And then for this matrix, you consider the operator, okay, lambda, which is associated with this pencil. Then we look for the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of this operator K lambda. Then in a matrix form, you can deduce that K lambda acting on she and she reversed, acting on alpha beta, can be represented in this way. Then the eigenvalue connection can be done in this way. Then you have a matrix, which is an anti-diagonal matrix, such that the entries depends on theta and the parameter lambda we have introduced. Then it's very simple result to show that the eigenvalues are related with theta and lambda in this way, as well as the eigenfunctions can be given in terms of your function, vector function associated with the Lorentz orthonormal polynomials and these parameters. Then we are interested in the polynomial solutions. Then I introduce polynomials Qn lambda in the variable y, defined as the ratio of omega n and omega c. And then it's important to notice that these polynomials are eigenfunctions of the operator K lambda. And notice that y and theta are related in this way. Then, by using a change of variable, we have immediately a result saying that you can represent y in terms of theta in this way. And then, with this transformation, you represent the unit circle in the real line as the union of two symmetric intervals with respect to the origin. Then we have the generalized dv theta connection in the following way. We have your CMB matrix. You consider the sheaved transformation, C hat, and then you consider, by using Szegő, the corresponding Jacobi matrix. And then the question is, can you find an explicit expression for the orthonormal polynomials Qn of Y, as well as what is the orthogonality measure? Then for these orthogonal polynomials, you can find an explicit expression with this given in terms of your Cn and Cn reversed Laurent orthogonal polynomials. And then by using the standard change of variable, you can find them as a linear combination of Chebyshev polynomials. What about the orthogonality measure? Concerning the orthogonality measure, we go from the interval minus pi pi, the circle, and we go to this union of symmetric intervals. And then we are able to find what is the measure supported on the union of these two intervals. Then, as a summary, we have proved that we can have a connection between the CMB matrix and a new matrix which is represented in terms of the pencil of the factors of capital C. Then we have the orthonormal polynomials with respect to this Jacobi matrix, and we have a method to generate new families of orthogonal polynomials. Notice that in the case of the paper by Derebiagin, Binet, and Zanov, the idea was very simple. The idea is to consider the CMB matrix with real entries. It's not the symmetric matrix. Then the idea is to add to this matrix the transpose. And then for this transpose matrix, you have a symmetric matrix. And this symmetric matrix can be represented as the squared of a Jacobi matrix associated with the transformation on the real line of the measure on the unit circle minus two times y. That means the reason why in the situation with lambda equal to one, you have such a representation. Then, as a very simple sample, we consider two examples. The first one is related with the Bernstein-Szegő polynomials, which are associated with a measure defined by d theta divided by absolute value of theta plus alpha squared. Then it's very well known that the corresponding sequence of orthogonal polynomials is defined at theta n minus one, theta plus alpha. What are the sequence of Laurent orthogonal polynomials? The sequence of Laurent orthogonal polynomials is defined in this way. And then, as a consequence, we can find what is the representation of the orthogonal polynomials associated with your pencil. Indeed, it is very simple result to prove that the even polynomials and the odd polynomials are represented in terms of Chebyshev polynomials of the second kind, as well as the corresponding measure can be given in some explicit way. The other example is related not with respect to an absolutely continuous measure, but a measure with a singular part. That means we have a Dirac mass located as theta equal to zero. It's very well known that the corresponding sequence of orthogonal polynomials is given in some explicit way as shown in the slide. And then the idea is, assuming this case, what is the sequence of Lorentz orthogonal polynomials, come back to orthogonal polynomials in the real line associated with this family. And then we can prove that the corresponding sequence of orthogonal polynomials associated with the pencil is exactly defined in terms of Chebyshev polynomials of the second kind. As well, we are able to find the corresponding measure. Then, as conclusion, I have considered a new approach to the so-called dB theta representation of the polynomials, Lorentz polynomials on the unit circle, in terms of families of orthogonal polynomials on the real line. That means that the introduction of this parameter lambda gives you a way to generate new families of orthogonal polynomials. Then we think that this is an interesting approach to show the connections between orthogonal polynomials on the real line, the corresponding Heisenberg matrix, orthogonal polynomials on the unit circle, and the corresponding Heisenberg matrix, and then you have some kind of jump. You go to the analog of the representation by the Jacobi matrix on the unit circle by using the CMB representation. That means it's a way to state the connection between these two families, basic families of orthogonal polynomials. This presentation is essentially the contents of a paper recently published in Journal of Approximation Theory in the June ICU of this year. Thank you very much for your attention.
Okay. Thank you, Paco. So are there any questions from the online audience or from the live audience in Sochi? Just unmute your microphone.
No questions? It's okay here.
You have a question, Sasha?
No, we don't have questions here.
So, Paco, I have a question for you.
Yeah.
Suppose you start with complex Verblonsky coefficients on the unit circle. Can you go to the real line in that case?
Initially, I think you can go to the real line, but there is a result, I think, by Binet and Zdanov from the middle of 90s, such that you can go to the real line to some infinite, semi-infinite interval.
Okay.
Okay? Then The idea is compactness of the image is related essentially to the fact that you have real Verbrunsky parameters. Otherwise, you have another representation. I think this is a paper by Binet and Zdanov and appeared in Integral Transform and Special Functions in the 90s.
Okay, thank you. Anyone else with a question? Apparently not. So I suggest we thank Paco once more for his talk. And now I'm wondering where the next speaker is, Miguel Tiaglov. He's not online. Oh, he's in Sochi.
Hello? Yeah, I'm offline.
Okay, so that.
Okay.
That explains.